Hey YouTube, Abanax142 here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can stop hacked or sidelined applications on your iPhone, iPod Touch or iPad from getting revoked in the future. And if you don't know what that means, it's basically if you install an app through Safari, such as through App Valley or Tutu, basically, as you'll probably know if you do this regularly, those applications can eventually stop working because Apple revokes the certificate for them. This aims to prevent that from happening. Now, this isn't a complete fix to completely prevent it from happening. If you already have apps on your device that are revoked and you can't open, this isn't going to fix that, and it isn't going to allow you to install applications from sources that are already revoked. So if you're trying to install something and it's saying this cannot be installed because it's revoked, basically, this isn't going to fix that. What this is going to fix is if you install an application and it is working and it gets revoked after you've installed this method that I'm going to show you here, it's actually going to stop that application from stopping working. So it should theoretically continue to work even after the application has been revoked by Apple. Now, obviously this isn't, you know, 100%. This may or may not work. I haven't really tried it out myself, but I've heard a lot of good things about it. And it is a very, very simple way of doing this. It's literally just installing a profile on your device. And so that what it does is makes it so that your device, every single time it checks to make sure the app is still being signed or isn't revoked, it's actually going to check a different website to basically Apple. It's not going to check Apple servers. It's going to check different ones. And that's using a VPN profile that I'll show you in a minute here. So if you go to my website, which will be linked in the video description, you're going to want to open it up in Safari, so not the YouTube app or Chrome or anything. Then you can go down here, you can read all the information I've got here about it, which I do recommend doing. But what you're going to find here is the download link section where you can see anti-revoke. If you tap on that, it'll open up a new website in a new tab, and you should get to this website here. And underneath install, you should see a thing called install profile. Now this website does have a little bit of an ad on here, so it may try and redirect you to the App Store or something sometimes. Or if an advert does appear up here, there may be a skip button that you have to press. But once you're on this page, basically, just tap on the Install Profile button that's down here. If you're on iOS 11, you'll get this little notification here. If you're on iOS 10 or below, you shouldn't get that. So as you can see, there's another ad that comes up. So if we just tap on Install Profile, then once it works, tap on Allow. Should redirect you to the App Store, or the settings application rather, and then if you tap install in the top right, if you have a passcode on your device, it'll ask you to input it here, so just do that if you do have one added. Then tap on next, install, and then install one more time. Then as you can see, it's done, installed, and all you need to do is tap on done in the top right, and it'll take you back to Safari. Now theoretically that is all you really need to do, but there are a couple things you might want to check just to make sure that everything is in place. So if you go to the settings application, and then you go down to general, and then if you go back down right at the bottom above profiles, you should see VPN. If you go in here, you should see a new anti-revoke official profile in here. Then make sure it's ticked. If you have multiple ones, just make sure you tap on it to tick it. Then if you tap on this little eye at the side, you should see in here a few little informations, and in the bottom toggle here that says connect on demand. You want to make sure that that is turned on like this, as it is by default. And after that, that's pretty much all you really have to do. There is supposed to be a thing on the website, so it does show you on here whether it's enabled or not, although I haven't actually got that to work, so I'm hoping that's just a little bug on the website. But yeah, that is something that they're probably going to need to work on. But yeah, what this is going to do is basically just make it so that your apps won't get revoked. There is one thing you need to bear in mind, so if you do reboot your device or just turn it off and on again, you are going to have to actually just unlock your device and leave it on the home screen for about 5 to 10 seconds just to make sure that the profile actually kicks in again and starts working. So if you do reboot your device, don't unlock it and then go to open one of these apps you've installed that's been revoked straight away. Just give it a few seconds, maybe 10 seconds, and then you can go ahead and do whatever you need to do. But yeah, that is pretty much it. If you have any luck with this, make sure you leave it down in the comments below. But if it doesn't work for you, make sure you post that down there as well. Just I'd like to get some little feedback on this to see how well it works. Because obviously I haven't really had an opportunity to test it since it only came out a couple days ago. But yeah, I've heard a lot of good things about it and it should be working perfectly fine. So just bear that in mind. And just remember, it's only going to fix applications that you've already got working on your device. It isn't going to allow you to fix ones that have already stopped working or that can't be installed. It's only going to work for ones that are already working on your device. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like I said, the links you need will be linked in the video description. Just click on that and open it up in Safari. And so yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.